हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक। माई सेल्फ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर गौरांग प्रजापति फ्रॉम महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। नाउ वी आर ऑलरेडी कवरिंग द टॉपिक ऑफ द प्लेट गर्डर। इन द प्रीवियस टू वीडियो आई हैव कवर द स्टेप नंबर 1 to 10। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू कवर द वेल्डेड कनेक्शंस ऑफ द प्लेट गर्डर। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द स्टेप नंबर 11, दैट इज वेल्डेड वेल कनेक्टिंग वेब प्लेट एंड फ्लेंज। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल प्रोवाइड द वेल्डेड कनेक्शन बिटवीन वेब प्लेट एंड वी कैन से फ्लेंज, मीन्स एट द जंक्शन ऑफ वेब एंड फ्लेंज। मीन्स इफ आई ड्रॉ द फिगर, जस्ट अ मिनट, सी दिस वन इज अवर आई सेक्शन, देन वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग वेल्डिंग ओवर हियर इन द क्रॉस सेक्शन। ओके, इफ यू ड्रॉ द साइड व्यू, देन जस्ट अ मिनट, then this will be side our side view, okay, so we are providing welding over here at the junction of web and flange over here. Okay, so for that one, say first of all assume the fillet well on the edge side of the weld, okay, and then the horizontal shear force per mm length of the criteria of the weld. We have already studied this one in the welded connection chapter in the subject of ESD or DOS. Qw equals to VAF Y bar divided by 2 into Iz. This one is the criteria. This one indicates the welding requirement, okay, of the plate girder. Where unknown V, that is we can say maximum shear force, that is Vz, step number 2, 2160 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. AF, area of the flange, we have already area of the flange 650 by 50, so 32500 mm square, and then we can say Y, that is we can say CG of the flange with respect to ZZ axis. Let's go back to the figure. See, this one is ZZ axis, so we need to calculate the CG of this flange with respect to ZZ axis. So its center, that is TF by 2, and the center of the wave, that is 900. So ultimately TF by 2, that is 50 by 2, and wave center, that is 1800 by 2. So ultimately this one is 25, this one will be 900, so ultimately total is 925. Okay, so see Y TF by 2 plus D by 2, that is 50 by 2 plus 1800 by 2, 925. So we have got all unknown, V, AF, Y bar, we have got this unknowns. And then I, that is this one Iz, moment of inertia of the plate girder with respect to XX axis. So typical box method, say BD cube by 12 minus small BD cube by 12. Okay, let me take you back to the I section once again. See, now first of all, as it is a symmetrical I section, so take, let's solve it using the box method which we are studying since the MOS. Capital BD cube by 12, 650 into 900 cube by 12. Okay, that's the overall box, and from that box deduct this term. Okay, means we can say we need to consider, we can say 650, out of that we need to deduct this one, 650 minus 1600 into this depth of wave 1800 cube by 12. So if we deduct this one, so ultimately I will get the remaining portion, this one, and we have already calculated the remaining one flange sections, that is this one. So ultimately I will get the whole I section. Clear? So by doing this one, I will get the value of Izz directly using the box method. So moment of inertia of the plate girder with respect to XX axis, capital BD cube by 12 minus small BD cube by 12. Capital B, 650 into 1900 cube by 12 minus this one, 650 minus 16 into 1800 cube by 12. So 6.34 into 10 raised to 10 mm raised to 4. Okay, so by doing this one, let's put down this value V, that is 2160 into 10 raised to 3. AF, that is 3250, Y bar 925, that is this one. twice IZ, that is 2 times 6.31 into 10 raised to 10. Simplifying this one, I will get the answer 512.06 Newton per mm. So let's convert it into kilonewton per mm, that is 0.512 kilonewton per mm. Now this one is the welding requirement if we want to connect flange with the web. Okay, so now let's provide the welded connection. So for that one, the basic formula of the welded strength of the weld per mm, P equals to LW into TT into FWD. Now LW, that is effective length of weld, that is 1 mm per mm we are designing, that's why LW equals to 1. TT, that stands for throat thickness, formula is always 0.7 into S. So for that one we need to decide the size of weld, that is S. S is usually assumed between 3 to 6 mm. So I am assuming as a maximum, that is 6 mm. Okay, so 0.7, see over here I will give the notation S, size of weld assume 6 mm. So for that one TT, 0.7 into S, so 0.7 into 6, so I will get 4.2 mm, that is as TT, throat thickness. Clear? And remaining one is FWD, that is design strength of weld, that is always assumed as maximum 189 for the field welding, sorry, for soft welding. Okay, and for field welding it is 158 Newton per mm square, but always assume the maximum, that is 189 for the soft welding. So we have got all three unknowns, LW, TT, FWD. Let's put down this one in this equation. LW 1, TT 4.2, this one is 189, so this one is the fixed answer, that is 793.8 Newton per mm. Let's convert it into kilonewton per mm, 0.793 kilonewton per mm. So what does this indicate? That if we are providing 1 mm effective length using the size of weld 6 mm and assuming the soft welding, we can give the strength of 0.793 kilonewton per mm, which must be greater than this QW, that is 0.512, which is greater, hence okay, no criteria is there, so no issue is there. So now let's provide the welded connection. So consider intermediate weld. Intermediate weld means we are providing weld like this, not in a completely continuous manner, but like in this manner. Okay, so consider intermediate weld. So for 1 mm effective length, center to center spacing ratio equals to P by QW. P is, we can say 0.793, and QW, that was 0.512. That is, just a minute, this one. P is 0.793, QW 0.512. So 0.793 divided by 0.512. So I got the answer ratio, that is 1.55. That is center to center spacing ratio. Now let's assume the effective length of weld. See, if I'm providing length like this, so this effective length, that is this one, 100 mm. I'm assuming this one is 100 mm. Assume the effective length of weld is, sorry, not 100, but 50 mm. You can assume 100 mm also, that is completely depends on you. So I'm assuming as a 50 mm. Okay, so we can say center to center spacing of weld equals to, just a minute, see, center to center spacing of weld equals to center to center spacing weld ratio, that is 1.55 multiplied by effective length of weld, which I have assumed over here 50 mm. By simplifying this one, I will get the center to center spacing of length, that is 77.5. see, this 77.5 means if I'm drawing for you got over here, see, this one is the length of weld 50, and center to center, that means this one, this dimension is how much? 77.5. And if I'm concerned about clear spacing between the weld, means I'm concerned about this dimension, this will be clear spacing. Say, then from center to center spacing, I need to deduct half of this one and half of this one. So ultimately, say, total length of weld will be deducted. Okay, so you can see over here, clear spacing equals to center to center spacing minus 2 times half of the effective length, 77.5 minus 2 times half of 50, so ultimately 27.5. Let me assume it as a round figure, say 50 mm. So clear spacing is 50 mm. Now as per the code of this one, say IS 800 10.5.5.2 page number 75, clear spacing should not be exceed, that is 12 times thickness, where T stands for minimum thickness. See, we have two dimensions, flange and web. Flange thickness is, I think, 50 mm, and web thickness is 16 mm. Obviously minimum will be 60 mm. So T equals to minimum thickness, that is thickness of web, that is 16. So 12 times 16, ultimately 192. So this clear spacing, which I have got as a 50 mm, should not be greater than clear spacing, that is how much? 192. Obviously it is not greater than that one, and it's okay. So I can say So provide 6 mm size fillet weld, right? Having clear spacing 50 mm and effective length of LS 50 mm on each side of the web. Let me show you in the sketch. See this one. This one is the side view, we can say longitudinal section, and this one is the welding which we have provided now. Okay, you can see the notation over here, 6 mm fillet weld, 50 in the bracket, 50 50 effective length, and we can say the clear spacing like that on the both sides. Okay, similarly this one is the, see this one is our I section. Okay, and if we cut the I section from here and see the view, this one, then I will get this one. This one is the top view, bottom flange, this one is our web, and this one is our stiffener. So this one is also the same welding which we have provided now. Okay, 6 mm fillet weld, clear? So this one is the step number 11, in which what we have done, we have provided the welded connection between web and flange at the junction of web and flange. Now we are going to provide the welded connection between web, this one is our web, and this one is our stiffener. We are going to provide this welding. Okay, so for that one, step number 12, weld connecting web plate and end stiffener. So for that one, so shear between the each component of the stiffener and web, Q1, formula stands for TW square divided by 5BS. Okay, now we have this formula in on page number 67. Okay, let me just a minute. On page number 67, just a minute. Yeah, we got the formula 8.7.2.6. Formula stands for, say, connection of intermediate stiffener to the web. Formula stands for TW square divided by 5BS. So as per page number 67, this formula, Q1 equals to TW square divided by 5BS. Now TW, that is thickness of wave, 16 mm, divided by 5BS, that is BS means outstanding width of the stiffener, that we have already assumed 218, that is was BQ. So 16 square divided by 5 BQ, that is 280. I got the answer 0.18 kN per mm. That's the criteria of Q1. Now then Q2, that is net SF divided by length of field. Okay, let's talk about net SF and length of weld. So first of all, let's talk about the length of weld, this one. So length of weld will be depth of web minus 2 times chamfer. We have provided chamfer for the welded connection only in case of the stiffener. So D, that is 1800 minus 2 times chamfer, that is 2 times 15, answer comes 1770 mm. So that's the length of weld. Then let's talk about the net SF. So in case of net SF, the criteria stands for VZ minus SF resisted by web. Now we already have the value of the VZ in step number 2. If we are talking about SF resisted by web, then at the end support, dispersion of the one side only. So ultimately this criteria will be FCDW by 2. Means, just let me clear this concept. See, if load is acting like this in between the plate girder, load get dispersed at like this 45 degree 45 degree, clear? And this one was our length, that was n1. So it was, we can say, 2 times triangle. This one we can say d by 2, and this one was also d by 2. Okay, this one was, we can say, d by 2 depth. Okay, but what happens if the load applies over here at the end? So it will get dispersed like this at 45 degree, but over here the plate girder is over, there is no plate girder on the right hand side, so load get dispersed only on one side, that is this one. So ultimately our this time n1 will be like this, of this one only. So ultimately in this case we can say n1 equals to, we can say, d by 2, with reference to the concept of the step number 8 design of load carrying stiffener. Clear? But in this case, as point load is not acting on the girder, so ultimately FCDW will be, we can say, 0. Okay, so it will be Vs minus FCDW by 2, where, see, I have shown it over here, just a minute, unknown parameters, I have shown it over here, where Vz, maximum SF, that is 2160, step number 2, and FCDW, that is buckling strength to the wave, page number 67 criteria, B1 plus N1 whole multiplied by TW into FCD, that is 0. Why 0? Because as the value of the KLR will be too much long, and also the point load is not acting on the girder. So ultimately FCDW will be 0. So ultimately net SF equals to Vz, that is 2160 kN. Clear? So we have got Q1 as well as, we can say, now length of weld, and net SF is there. So I can easily calculate Q2. So Q2 equals to net SF divided by length of weld. Net SF 2160, length of weld 1770, ultimately 1.22 kN/mm. So I got the answer Q1 over here. Now Q2, let's do the summation. So ultimately QW equals to Q1 plus Q2. We got Q1.18, 1.22. So I got the answer 1.4. Now let's calculate the strength of the weld on each side. So strength of each side of the weld equals to Q equals to QW by 2, 1.4 by 2. It will be 0.70 kN/mm. So this one is our requirement. Okay, so if you want to connect the stiffener with respect to wave, then we need to provide this much strength in the welded connection. And we have already calculated in the previous step that P was our 0.793. See, we have already solved this one, don't need to do it again. Okay, P equals to LWTTFWD, LW1TT, as I have assumed the size of weld 6 mm, TT, that is 0.7 into 6, 4.2, and FWD 189. So we got the answer 793.8 Nm/mm. So it will was 0.793 kN/mm, which is greater than this requirement, that was 0.70. And okay, so we need to provide the now clear spacing as well as effective length of the weld. So consider intermediate weld. Now the remaining portion is as it is, like the previous step. For 1 mm effective length, center to center spacing of weld equals to P divided by QW. P 0.793, QW was 0.70, so the ratio is 1.13. Let's assume the size of effective length of weld, that is 50 mm. So let's multiply these two terms, so I will get the center to center spacing. Center to center spacing equals to 1.13 into 50. So I will get the answer 56.6. Now let's talk about the clear spacing. It was center to center spacing minus 2 times half of the effective length of weld. 56.6 minus 2 times half of 50, so ultimately 6.6. so I am assuming at least minimum 50 mm, and it should not be greater than 12 times minimum thickness. Now both the thickness of the flange as well as stiffener is 16, so 12 times 16, that is 192. 50 mm is not greater than 192, hence okay, we can say the same statement like previous step. Provide 6 mm size of fillet weld having clear spacing 50, and effective length of weld is also 50 mm. Clear? And then I can show this one in this case, this one, 6 mm fillet weld, see, 50 50 50, and this one is our end bearing stiffener, that is this. And again this one, yeah, this is the welding which we have calculated right now in step number 12. Clear? So in the end you will need to draw this sketch. Okay, see, this one is our side view, step number 13. This one is our sketch, this one is our side view of the I section. See, cross section will be like this. Okay, I'm drawing a bit of rough figure, and over here end stiffener will be there on the both side. So I'm watching it from the side. Okay, so this one will be my top and bottom flange, this will be my end stiffener. Clear? So this one is end stiffener, this one is the welded connection of step number 12, this one flange and web, that is welded connection of step number 11. Flange dimension, the dimension, cross sections dimensions, say 50 1850, like that, and the span of the girder, that is 24 mm, and this one is our web. Then if we cut the I section from the top and watching it from, if we cut the I section, okay, from the center, and if we are watching it from the top, then we will get this view. So in the background bottom flange will be there, this one is our wave, okay, and this one will be our stiffener. See, I have given all the notations over here. This one is the welded connection of step number 11, connection between flange and wave. Okay, then this is the whole flange, this one is our wave. Just a minute, this one will be my wave and these two are our stiffener. These two are our stiffener. Okay, and then in the cross section view, typical I section, these two are the stiffeners and this is the welded connection of step number 12. These are the stiffener, this one, these are the cross section dimension. Okay, so there are total 13 steps in the design of unsiphon plate girder. Okay, hope so you got the last two steps properly. Myself, Assistant Professor Gaurang Prajapati, signing off.